guys, welcome back to Eatown. Today, Richie's back with us, and we have a new host today, Kevin.
Hello.
We're going to be going around the town of Eatonton, looking at all the historic homes and maybe some different ones and all the beautiful holiday decorations, guys. Really excited. We're waiting on Emily Holt from the Eatonton Chamber of Commerce, and she should be pulling up soon.
Isn't that her?
Yeah, let's go.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. So are you guys ready to go see some historic homes?
Yeah, where do you want to go first?
Let's go to the Rosser's house.
Okay. This is Richie and this is Kevin.
Hey, Emily.
Nice to meet you.
All right, buckle up, guys.
Safety first.
The town has definitely evolved, but we still like to keep our history and heritage.
So what's this home?
This is the Rosser's home. So this was built back in the 1880s.
Oh, wow.
And so they came back, I want to say they moved back here in the 90s, and Tom Rosser, he was in the corporate world, and they moved back here, and they're actually a part of the rebuilding and developing the Plaza Arts Center. They were one of the families that raised the money to be able to get it to where it is today.
So. Oh, wow. It's really cute. I like the little nutcrackers out front.
Yeah.
Do you guys want to get out?
Yeah, we can go take a look.
All right.
What kind of home is this?
This is a Victorian-styled home.
How many more houses are like this in this county?
We have over 100 in the county, and then just in the city alone, we have 70 homes.
That's a lot.
That are along the Antebellum Trail.
I know before we had a car, we used to walk these streets a lot, and there's just so many gorgeous homes.
There are a lot.
Out of a long time ago, y'all.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, we were set in make. Oh, Lordy, make everything.
To the Sicklin House, and that is owned by Murray and Mary Eyre.
Oh, awesome.
Mm-hmm. So what's special about that house?
So that house is a Greek Revival house, a very traditional Greek Revival house, and it's very big. It's one of the biggest homes in the area.
So when was this house, what year was this house built?
This house was built in 1855, and a little bit about the architecture, it has been relatively not altered. It's just been updated, you know, the windows, things like that, but they have a full apartment down below. So it's a three-story home, and the apartment was renovated in the 1900s, and the owners currently, Murray Eyre, the heirs, they haven't really done much, just updated it, and they've kept even the wall colors on the inside, the interior, the exact same color that they were.
So Emily, can you tell us a little bit more about this home?
Yes, this home is what they call 4 for 4. So there are four rooms on each level. There's three levels of the home, and they're the exact same size and same height, so floor to ceiling. And this home was a second home. The original family that built it, they had a home out in the country, and they wanted a home that was closer to the city, so they built this one.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm.
So the landscape is beautiful.
It is. The previous owner was a landscape designer, and so she built the fountain area right there. There's a garden in the back as well as a pond.
Okay, where to next?
We are gonna go to the Hayban house, which is now Dot to Dot Inn.
Okay. Yeah, I've heard about Dot to Dot. Mm-hmm. It's owned by
Karen Henry Garrett and her husband. And they moved here about 2 years ago from Boston. She had a restaurant up in Boston that was very well known. It was Dot to Dot Cafe. And she came back here wanting to open up an inn in a historical home. And she liked Eatonton and what Eatonton had to offer. And so she opened, a little over a year ago, and she recently just started catering again, and she also does brunch on Sundays, so from 10 to 2.
Hi. I'm Karli.
I'm Karen.
This
Hi.
Is Ritchie.
I'm Ritchie.
Where's your coat, Ritchie?
Okay. I left it somewhere, but it's okay.
Okay. This is the owner of Dot to Dot. So why don't you tell us a little bit about the history of this beautiful home?
So it was the first white-columned home in Eatonton. Built by a family, I think it was two brothers, so there's a sister one to this, also in Eatonton, much, much grander. But ours was the first, and it's that typical 4x4 rooms, sort of a square, it's a great house. We now run it as a bed and breakfast, trying to get into the Christmas spirit a bit, with the help of Roxy, actually, because that wreath up there has been donated
by
our
decorations are great.
We're getting there. It's really odd to do Christmas here because we were in Boston before, and yeah. By now it's snow and we're shoveling, and this is still warm and light and sunny.
Yeah, if we ever get snow, it's just like a little dust, and they shut everything down.
I understand
that.
You're not ready for snow at all. But you know, it's nice. It's nice to have this here. It's mm-hmm. crisp. We run this as a bed and breakfast. We also run it as an event venue. So we have lunches and teas and dinners. And various people have hosted parties here. So we had a big kickoff party last October when we opened. That was our, grand opening. Mm-hmm. And since then we've had several events, so sort of Christmas do's and wedding events, engagement parties, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So we're trying to use the house to its full potential.
We don't
We don't actually need this big house to live in. I mean, it's nice to live
in. It's beautiful,
but
yeah.
We're really trying to use it.
Yeah, it's awesome what you guys have done here.
Thank you. You should have to come inside one day and have a look where it's warmer.
That'd be great. Yeah. Thank you so much.
No problem.
All right, we're having fun here. Little Grinch party here after the Christmas parade in Eatonton, Georgia. This is a great place. Big show for you, huh? People love the Grinch. All right, brother. Appreciate you. Thanks for coming, Grinch.
Okay, so now we are headed to our last stop, and the home is owned by the Mangnums, and it is a Greek Revival home that was built in the 1850s. They've been living at this home for quite a while, so we will hopefully get to hear some from Miss Millie about the history of the home.
Miss Millie, this is Karli.
Hi, it's so nice to meet
you. Hi, Karli, nice to meet you.
I just want to know a little bit about the history of your house.
Ah, okay. The house is 1846, mm-hmm. built in 1846, and the first mayor of Eatonton lived here. But it was built by a lawyer by the name of Jefferson Adams, and he also built a house on the square for his daughter, which we also own.
That's crazy. So,
yeah, so it's... there was a cow in the backyard named Bessie Jane, so we have a lot of history on it.
Yeah, that's amazing. It's beautiful. Yeah. And you guys decorate every year, right?
We do. Mm-hmm. We do. We think hopefully it adds to the community a little bit.
Yes, mm-hmm.
And
it definitely does.
Yeah, it's a very special season.
So. It is. Thank you so much for letting us come and view your home and talk with you. Mm-hmm.
Well, thank you. Thank you. It's fun to decorate 15-foot ceilings.
Oh, I bet. I can
you
imagine.
Miss the fun on the ladders with it.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
So, that's great. But well, you guys, it's nice of it's you nice. To do this for the community.
Yeah, it was nice meeting you. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much.
All right, Emily, thank you so much for taking us around. We yeah. learned a lot today and got to see some beautiful houses.
Yeah.
This was really fun.
Good. You're welcome. I'm glad I got to.
Yeah, did you guys have fun?
Yeah. I had a lot of fun without a jacket.
Yep. First Christmas time in Eatonton. It's going good so far. So.
Yeah.
All right, well, thank you again. It was so much.
You're welcome.
We had a great time.
Thank you guys for
coming.
Thank
you, Emily.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.
All right, everyone. Thank you so much for watching this episode of E-Town.
And thank you, Kevin, for joining us.
You're welcome.
We had a lot of fun going around, seeing the beautiful decorations in Eatonton, and learning a lot about the history of the homes.
So we'll see you guys in the next episode.
Happy holidays!